feature interview story come out on him. So if you're curious about what his role looks like, be sure to check it out.
Can Nicholas Lorenz parlay a top qualifier status into a Pro-lite final win, or will we see a repeat winner? It's time to go Pro-lite racing in Deadwood. And there is the takeoff. We may have had a jump on the start. Looked like maybe Theo Pryor left a little bit early. We'll have to see if he gets the throw the black flag. But right now, Lorenz has got the stud boy hole shot.
And man, what a turnaround that would be for Nick Lorenz this season. He's been so strong tonight. We see him out front. Looks like we have a little bit of chaos here in the Polaris corner.
That was Travis Kern getting off his sled. And here is Lorenz trying to hang on to the lead. But he's getting pressured from behind. He'll jet away a little bit. Look at that traffic jam there as Theo Poirier runs in second. Peterson fighting it out for the number three spot right now. He is to the inside of the Anderson sled as they come through that split lane and then meet up. And Anderson able to stave off Peterson for the moment.
And it doesn't look like we have seen any sort of dock or flagging on Theo Poirier for the start there. So, you know, all fair game thus far. He's looking very, very strong. And that second place position was 1.665 seconds behind your race leader, Nick Lorenz.
Theo is the winner one round to go in this Pro-Lite category. Anderson looking for his first win of the season. Back there from third, Peterson, a two-time winner, sitting in fourth. Riley Bester rounding out the top five right now. And Lorenz's teammate, Carson Allred, trying to get up there as well. Wow, Anderson with a little bit of an unhappy landing there behind Theo Poirier as they continue to battle here through the Skidoo Rhythm section for second and third.
That's what's tough about this track, because it doesn't make it particularly smooth for these riders, and what they experienced one lap ago is not necessarily going to be the same game plan on the next lap, so not always smooth sailing for these riders. We'll see how well they can continue to navigate, but Corbin Anderson, if he's able to maintain that podium position, that would make it three in a row.
He was trying to set up maybe for an outside in on Theo Poirier, but Theo at the end of the straightaway had a little more gas to go and was able to gap out enough to stave it off as Anderson gets twisted in the air coming off the FXR jump. He'll again stay to the outside here as they come through this Articat Rhythm section and the U.S. Air Force flyaway.
And Corbin Anderson for Anderson Racing teammates with his brother Cameron Anderson, who appears to be out with an injury currently, also teammates with Megan Verdur. He's feeling good this season. He has had a wrist injury earlier this fall, but he's fighting through it. And he said he really honestly doesn't feel it when he's on track. He feels it when he is off of track. So it's not appearing to very much affect him here. But Theo Poirier, Nick Lorenz, distancing himself just a little bit off of Theo Poirier.
That would be a perfect night for Nicholas Lorenz. He won both of his qualifying rounds earlier tonight. So to pick up the win here would be to get out the broom and sweep the card in this Pro-Lite division. And Lorenz looking super comfortable and super fast at the front of the field.
Very much so. He's proven to be, last year, one of the most consistent and durable riders in the field, and one of the older riders here at Pro-Lite at just 22 years of age. So he has a bit of experience in this class.
He charges through the Skidoo Rhythm section, and we'll flash back to look at the battle for third place here as Anderson trying to keep Adam Peterson behind him, has been able to gap out a little bit. And there's Carson Allred, so the jumping motorsports lead right now bookending the top five.
Carson Allred with a good run in his qualifying rounds. And we see our current Pro-Lite points leader, Adam Peterson, up into the P4 position, the 113 Polaris for Team LaValle.
And he is trying to draw in on Corbin Anderson. And Anderson, meanwhile, has seen Theo Poirier screw down a couple of seconds on him. There's Theo there at the top of the screen just for a moment. And Peterson getting close to trying to put a move on Anderson here through the U.S. Air Force flyaway. But Anderson able to run his way past the Amsoil finish line jump and again open up a little bit of a margin here on Adam.
You know, they say to get these passes, you got to go where they ain't. But man, that can be really tricky, especially right now in that Ram Trucks corner.
And the thing about Anderson here, the first couple of laps, he was running outside of that Polaris turn. He switched the lineup. Obviously feels like it's a faster or more comfortable line now on the inside of that corner.
Definitely. And like you said, they were touching it up just before this Pro-Lite final. And I'm curious to see kind of the strategy behind changing up his line there. Is it a matter of the track conditions or just trying to try something new? You know, switching up your line is definitely something that that riders typically might fear away from. So definitely taking a risk there, changing up his lines.
Oh, yeah. Halfway through, it's Lorenz, Poirier, Anderson, Peterson, and Allred as your top five. As again, Peterson trying to put a move on Anderson here as they come back through the Ram Trucks corner. Now the other side. I tell you what, it looks like right now in this battle between Anderson and Peterson, Anderson has got the grunt coming off the corner. He's getting more torque, more power down to the snow, and he's able to gap Peterson.
Most definitely. And what we're seeing, not just in Pro-lite, but in Pro as well, is on these straightaways, specifically heading towards the Polaris corners, you might see the tracks of these snowmobiles getting a little bit swirly. So, you know, it's making these drivers, they have to be on their toes and be able to capitalize in the event misfortune happens for the rider in front of them.
At the front of the field, Lorenz has 3 seconds on Field Poirier. Anderson right now in the final podium spot, followed by Peterson. They've been battling all race long, and now Peterson's going to have traffic in his line when they come into the Polaris turn. And it looks like the one slip moving to the outside more, but you can see more traffic ahead. And Peterson coming up over the other side, coming out of that Polaris turn. He just got a big old face full of that heavy wet snow roost.
Adam Peterson just over a second. He is 0.686 seconds behind your third place position right now of Corbin Anderson. So he's been closing in on that gap, slowly but surely.
Nick Lorenz working his way through traffic here with a few laps left to go in this Pro-Lite final. Looks like he's putting the lap on Tyler Uman on the number 25. Already had only qualifying through the LCQ tonight. We'll clear him as we get the look from above here. Theo Poirier with the 728. He is in second, and he is buried in traffic right now.
And a rider we haven't talked about who's kind of mid-pack here. We have Evan Dowd currently in seventh. He is just coming back from a dislocated shoulder, but no time off really for him. Didn't have to skip any rounds, so it's good to see Evan Dowd back into the mix here. Currently mid-pack in seventh.
Watching Nicholas Lorenz come off the inside of the Polaris turn here as he put a lap on the 201 of Travis Curran, who had an issue earlier on in this contest. And the gap between second and third is starting to narrow here as we head into the final couple of laps. Anderson putting on a charge, trying to get to Theo Poirier.
He is in our third place position right now, Corbin Anderson. He's been able to distance himself just a little bit from Adam Peterson in fourth. We have just a couple laps the distance remaining here on lap 16.
So Lorenz off the corner. We go back to watch this battle for second, third, and fourth as they get stretched out a little bit down the straightaway off the U.S. Air Force flyaway. So a couple laps left to run here. And as they come off the corner, Anderson hunting for that number two spot. Hasn't been able to get close enough to put the move yet on Theo. They're closing in on the white flag when they come by this time at the Amsoil finish line.
And if Nick Lorenz can hang on to this for just a few more paces, and what a storybook finish that would be. Quite the night for Nick Lorenz, who has had some tough luck in the two opening weekends at ERX Motor Park and in Dubuque, Iowa.
So we're into the final lap in this Pro-Lite final. Nicholas Lorenz on the Polaris Jack Lynch sponsored number 572 comes into the Articamp rhythm section. He'll work his way through the whoops here in front of the grandstands. Third, the U.S. Air Force flyaway. And for the first time this year, Nicholas Lorenz lights the flames in Deadwood as he wins in Pro-Lite. And Theo Poirier holds on for the number two spot, holding off Corbin Anderson, who will complete the podium. Adam Peterson, your point leader, finishes fourth. Carson Allred, fifth. 6 through 10, Anson Shield, Evan Dowd, Matt Lemorier, Taylor Cole, and Riley Bester. And a big celebration down there with the Judnick team as everybody offering congratulations. Abel Haar with a big bear hug there for Nicholas Lorenz. He goes perfect, wins both rounds of his qualifying, and parlays it into a Pro-Lite final victory here at the U.S. Air Force Snocross National. We'll meet up with Nicholas Lorenz and the rest of our podium finishers when we come back with more Amsoil Championship Snocross powered by Ram Trucks.
Once might have been lucky. Twice.
U.S. Air Force Snowcross National in Deadwood. Let's meet our winner in Pro-Lite, who is standing by with Josie Christian.
Nick, what a day for you. Absolutely dominating out there. This track is obviously a good fit for you, but forget the points, kind of forget everything. You needed this win. What worked for you today?
What I went through today was amazing. I mean, 1-1-1. I got every single start today, and I mean, that makes a difference in this class, especially on these tight tracks. I mean, it definitely made the difference in that final.
Couldn't get much better today. You said you were so comfortable going into today. Who do you got to thank tonight?
I got to thank Johnny Motorsports, Colleen and Juddy. I mean, they've believed in me, you know, for the last 4 years with them, and I've had some injuries and stuff, but they haven't stopped believing in my father, Brad Lorenz, and his girlfriend. They're always backing me. Climbs here, they have some awesome gear. Jack Blings, Walker Evans, Red Bull. I mean, I wouldn't be able to be up here without them.
Well, a huge congratulations on your first place finish.
Thank you.
Nick Lorenz picks up the win in the Pro-lite final here tonight at the U.S. Air Force Snowcross National. And now let's get ready to meet our runner-up finisher, who was on the top step of the podium one round ago, from Quebec aboard the Articat number 728, Theo Poirier.
I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I believe every lie that I ever told.
Theo, we saw you last year up on the podium. Welcome back. But what part of this track do you think benefits your riding style?
I mean, I like when it's rough and it's tight, and this is all about this track. I was feeling super good. I mean, my mechanic did a good job on my sled. My sled was ripping, and Ryan Duncan on the clutching. Cannot ask for a better sled. And everybody, Paul, Woody, Kim, they're awesome with me this year so far. I love being here, and I'm so happy.
And who would you like to thank tonight?
I would like to thank FXR for sure with the new combat goggle and the nice gear. Bubba Burger, Hayes Briggs, Studboy Traction, CNA Pro Ski, Rock Speed FX, Nitrile Lubricant, General Formulations, Fowler Parts, Speedworks, and Idahoan and Sunoco, and for sure Arctic Cat for the sled this year again. It's awesome to be on a nice sled like that, and I'm so happy. Thanks everybody also at home, my family, my friends, and my trainer that works hard for me. Thanks everybody.
Huge congratulations on your second place finish.
So first place to a Polaris, second to an Arctic Cat, and finishing third on a Ski-Doo out of Allenton, Michigan, the number 17, Corbin Anderson.
Corbin, you were running fast out there. What technique did you use in order to gain and control such good speed?
I don't know. I just have to guess.
And who would you like to thank tonight?
I'd like to thank my whole team, Anderson Racing, Ski-Doo, MBRP, D's, XPS, Walls, Studboy, Rox, Enzo, and most of all, one of our biggest sponsors, Fly. They help us out a lot. Some sick-ass gear.
Well, congratulations on your third place finish.
Yeah, thank you.